is Grandjulie and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a Avana plastic surgery review. So a little disclaimer before I hop into the video, this review is going to be on Avana plastic surgery as a whole. When I say a whole, I mean the clinic, the people who work at the front desk, the nurses, the assistants, the surgeons. It's going to be a whole overview about my experience dealing with this plastic surgery center while getting my BBL surgery. So for those of you who are new to my channel, make sure you stop right here, click this playlist, and start from the beginning, because how can you just jump into the journey and not see where I came from to where I'm at now? Started from the bottom, now we're here. But no, for real, and if you're a returning viewer, thanks for making it this far. I officially hit 9 weeks 2 days ago, so it's been a long journey, and I've been so grateful that you guys wanted to follow along on this journey with me. Love the support on my videos, love when you guys share my videos, comment down, and all that other jazz. So, enough talking, make sure you subscribe to my channel, like this video, and let's just hop right into the review. So I'm going to break this video up into maybe like 3 parts. The first part will be customer service. The second part is going to be the surgeons and my surgeon specifically. And the third part is just going to be like a what I recommend, yes, no, overall rate, such and such. So the customer service at Avana Plastic Surgery, I know like you guys are in these Facebook groups and you see these comments from these other women and dolls who've dealt with like really bad customer service at Avana plastic surgery. Me, for the most part, I feel like for any plastic surgery office who has like a lot of clients coming in, I feel like their communication skills from 1 to 10 was like maybe like a 7. And I'm saying this like wholeheartedly, thinking about how many people that they have to deal with on a daily basis. Avana is not like, you know, 305 plastic surgery. But it's a well-known plastic surgery office, so I expected the customer service to be not 100%, but it wasn't like piss poor like what I saw people saying in these surgery groups. Mind you, this is just my personal opinion from my personal experience with them. My surgery coordinator was Monique. I know after I paid my surgery deposit, Monique, she was kind of iffy. To be honest, it's like I will call and they'll be like, oh, she's not in the office. They'll leave a request for her to call me back. 2-3 days later, no call back. And then she'll call back sometimes on a 4th day. And it's like, well, my problem's already fixed now. Or she won't call back. And I have to call back again like 2-3 days later. And then I finally speak to her. And then like she'll tell me, or they'll tell me, okay, we'll send you what you're asking for. Don't get it till like 2 days later. And it's just like, they're very iffy, but it's like an expected iffy. I didn't get like a, oh, you're playing in my face type of, you know, bad customer service. Because a lot of people felt like after they paid their deposit, the surgery coordinator and the front desk people just went missing. That wasn't my personal experience. I still got my calls answered and my emails, like the documents I requested sent to me. It just wasn't as fast as I would have liked it. But then I had to sit back and think, how many other people are requesting the same thing? How many other people are calling the same office? So I had to just sit back and really work on my patience. What else can I say about the customer service? The post-op department, I'm going through an issue with them now. So I requested my before and after pictures, and they only uploaded my before pictures from surgery and also the before pictures that I took the day of before I laid it on the table. The pictures that I want to see are the pictures that I took the day after, like during my post-op appointment. So this, I've been asking for these pictures for like 2 weeks now and they still have not been posted on my portal. So at this point, when Monday come, I'm going to really call and snap, because I've been gracious and I've given them like 2 weeks to run me my pictures. Like, I just really want to see myself like the day after surgery, just to compare. So overall, I give the customer service like a 7, 6.5, 7, like, and that's just me being nice. Also, like I said, it really just depends on your experience, depends on your surgery coordinator, and also just depends on like who do you call. in the office and if they're having a good day or not. Because sometimes when I do call, they do like get me what I need and get me to the right department in a timely manner. And when other times, it's really like a waiting game. So it just depends on you and like who you catch on a good day or not. Second part is my surgeon. So the surgeon I had was Dr. Dress. I freaking love Dress. Like, I cannot say this enough. I love Dr. Dress. Like, he gave me exactly what I want. And like, from my first time meeting him during post-op, I just knew I went with the right person, because I went to my post-op appointment, well, my pre-op, I'm sorry. From my pre-op appointment, I just knew I went with the right surgeon, because originally I scheduled with Dr. Meridian, and as you guys know, like he was out of Avana for like a long time. I had my surgery in November, and it's January, and I still don't think he's back yet, just for some context. So I called, they told me I had to pick between Dress and Meniscus, and I was really stressed out, and so I just picked Dress because I wanted that natural body look, and I was just like, he can't fuck me up that bad, excuse my language. So when I was in my pre-op appointment, I just signed papers, they took pictures, and during your pre-op, you typically don't meet the doctor, but ask the surgery coordinator or the lady who was working with me and take my pictures, can I speak to Dr. Dress, just because I have some questions that I need answered, and I just want to like get familiarized with him. So she said, you know, he probably just finished up a surgery, or he's about to go in surgery, but she's going to go see if like he'll come speak to me before, like real quick. So 2 minutes went by and he comes into the room, he speaks to me, like he took the time out of his day to come speak to me, which he really didn't have to, but the fact that he really like stepped to the side to come speak to me was really appreciated. He answered all my questions, I showed him like some of my wish picks, he took a look at me, he told me what he could and couldn't do, and he told me like what would be realistic for my frame. And he just really gave me like a really good sense of like comfort, and like he settled the little bit of nerves that I did have. Mind you, I didn't go into surgery with nerves because this is something I wanted to do for like the longest. So I wasn't nervous. It was just more so, all right, we're here, let's get this over with, you know, like type thing. So it was just amazing that I spoke to him. And the next day of surgery, I didn't really see him that much until I got into the surgery room, but during my surgery, like my patients ran so thin. My call time to be at Avana was 9 o'clock, right? So I got there at 9 o'clock and I waited maybe like 2 hours to get to the back to do my my urinalysis and my drug test, and then I didn't get on the table, or I didn't see an anesthesiologist till like 1 o'clock. So I was there from 9 to maybe like 2 o'clock, 1:30 when I laid on the table. I laid on the table at 1:30. I got to the bottom at 9 o'clock in the morning. Like, they had so many women in that room with the same surgery date as me. I was like, ain't no way. Like, y'all need to wrap it up, like come on, because the more I'm waiting, the more I'm getting nervous. Like, I wasn't nervous at first, but just that waiting was like, all right, what are we doing? So then eventually the anesthesiologist came and saw me and brought me back to the back room. They put the IV in me, they put the stuff to make me fall asleep. Y'all, I do not remember falling asleep. The last thing I remembered, he was talking to me about being a Virgo, because his daughter was a Virgo, etc., etc. And then I felt myself drifting. I don't remember myself drifting off, but then I remember waking up in recovery. I was freezing, and it was this girl next to me. She was screaming. When I say she was screaming, I was like, shut the fuck up. Like, excuse my language, but I was just like so aggravated because I thought I was gonna wake up screaming, and my pain tolerance is like zero. I really have like the worst pain tolerance ever, the lowest pain tolerance ever. So I woke up, I was asking questions. I was like, where am I? Like, what's going on? Am I okay? I was like, I'm alive. Like, I was like, I'm alive. Oh my gosh. She was like, yeah, you're alive. And I'm like, can I have some water? I'm thirsty and I'm cold. It was freezing. Recovery was freezing. So I woke up in my faja And then she gave me some water. I went back to sleep, maybe for like 10, 20 minutes. And then she woke me up because my brother finally came to pick me up. She helped me into the wheelchair and she rolled me off. And I, if you see in my my surgery vlog, I'm like, y'all, I'm alive. Like, I was just so happy to be out and like have it over with. And so that was my experience for the day of surgery. Now, post-op was a mess. When I went in for post-op, my call time for post-op was 11 o'clock. When I signed my contract and everything, they told me during your post-op appointment, you're gonna get your first massage, they're gonna check your incisions, and just doing like checkup to see how you're feeling. I get to post-op, it was like 20 people in that post-op office. So if you guys been in Avana's post-op office, you know it's not even like really big. So I'm just sitting there. I'm like, hi, my appointment is at 11. Dun-dun, here for my massage. Also, blase, blase. She's like, we don't have you scheduled for a massage. I'm like, do you have my post-op appointment scheduled? She was like, yeah. I'm like, okay, they told me that I get my first massage during post-op, so what are you telling me? She was like, oh no, I don't know why they've been telling people that, but you have to call to schedule your massages, blase, blase, blase. So I'm like, okay, so what do we do during post-op if I don't get my massage? She's like, oh, just go in to see a nurse, she asks you a few questions, she checks your incisions, X, Y, and Z. So, y'all know, like, after surgery, you're not, the day after surgery, you're not 100% yet. So they had us standing in there for so long. I eventually like laid my robe out on the floor and I laid down. I was like about to go to sleep. And then maybe like 20, 30 minutes later, they called me back to see the nurse and take my pictures. The girl was like, oh, you're already so flat. And I know. So it was just that. Like, I did not like the way, because you're already aggravated because you just had surgery, your body hurts, you're tired, and you want me to wait an hour and not even like get the massage that I was promised during my post-op experience. So that really just threw me, and it threw me for a loop that they were just so unorganized in that aspect. But other than that, it just felt like I was just going through like a regular type of thing. Like, they could have been better in certain areas for sure, like scheduling and just like time management for sure. They could have, you know, extra work on that. But I also just feel like you have to take into consideration how massive, like, how can I put this? You have to take into account how many people they have to deal with on a daily basis. And like, I, even though I've always called and like I try not to have attitude with people when I call or when I'm aggravated, because you never know the type of day they're having, and also I wouldn't want them having attitude with me, so I tried to keep it cute and cordial. But it was some people in that office that was just like snapping, like cursing the people out. And I was just like, and the nurses was just taking it. They was like, I'm so sorry. They kept it professional. That's one thing when it comes to like customer service, like speaking and in person, they kept it very professional. But other than that, overall rating for Avana plastic surgery is a cool 6.5 on the customer service scale. The rating for Dr. Dress on his own personal scale is a 9. Like, I would really recommend Dr. Dress to everybody, and that's just the matter of the fact. So, that's the end of my Avana plastic surgery review and Dr. Dress review video. Please like this video, share this video. Cheers to 9 weeks, and I'll be back next week. Make sure you subscribe. Also, leave down a comment, because I don't know like what other BBL style videos to record. I feel like I done probably already did all of them. But I'm gonna do 1 3-month and 1 6-month update, like a body update. So leave in the comments and tell me what other videos you guys would like to see, because I really wanna put out more content for you guys. And I also have a few other things in the works. So make sure you're following my surgery page at diaryofajb. Gonna leave it right here. And also my personal page, angeliejb. So yeah, also I'm gonna do a quick little stand up. This is how the waist is looking, y'all. I have my faja and a waist trainer. So if you want to also see how I compress, I have a video on compression as well. See, I have a video on almost everything. So see you guys in my next video. Bye.